Yesterday, the German Bundestag passed a law that regulates the payment of tax of German beer. It was concluded to pay tax on beer with 34 cents per liter instead of 21 today. Because of this decision, millions of cyclists went on the German streets today, like here in Berlin, to raise their voices against the new law that causes a drastic rise in beer prices, an average of more than 10%, so that many Germans could no longer afford their daily ration of beer. Hammelzeit. Johan goes swimming and jumps into the water.
Da lebt noch. Scheiße.
Berlin. As of today, in Germany applies a smoking ban in one-way streets. The German Bundestag passed a law that forbids every smoker, except zoo and bank employees, to smoke contrary to the driving direction in one-way streets.
Bloop bloop, bloop bloop bloop, bloop 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 bloop.
The reactions are different. Many people support the new rule, but there are also opponents of the smoking ban in one-way streets. A lot of smokers feel discriminated. Leipzig. Today, the new film of Konnewitz Pictures is coming to the movie theaters. Chemie Grundkurs, der Film, approaches the issue of a broken down chemistry course, searching for the all-embracing answer. The movie is full of state-of-the-art special effects and is fascinating till the last minute of the film. 9 of 10 stars.
In the last weeks, the Halver World Championship fascinated millions of fans from all over the world. Today, the first match was played. The new best female player in the world comes from Indonesia. In a hard game, she dominated over the sportswoman from the German Democratic Republic. Our sports reporter has watched the game and could even interview the winner.
Today, once again, the Halma World Cup brought us a surprise. Indonesia versus the German Democratic Republic. The newcomer versus the top dog. Today's game was destined to make history. Due to the very offensive lineup, the GDR started well into the game. But Indonesia reacted wisely and soon the game slipped out of the hands of trainer Mikkel's team. The fans might be cheering, but the game remains relatively calm up to now. One could easily think that this is still the warming up exercise. Only a few great moves up to now. Not only from the GDR, but also from Indonesia. Both players are very concentrated. The game is evenly matched. While the team of Indonesia plays extremely sovereign, pressure is increasing for the GDR, which already won the World Cup 4 years ago. The Halma Stadium is overcrowded. More than 50,000 fans came to support their team. The atmosphere is fantastic. Thought the second half of the game started rather defensive. In the 85th minute, Indonesia provokes with a fantastic run. The GDR now has to respond or it might lose control. Now the tension's higher than ever before. And the GDR got the first real chance for a breakthrough there, but offside! And now she's begging the ref! Yellow card! What a shame! No wonder the fans are head up! In fact, the whole nation is furious! Now, let's see the move once again. The player advances from the back row through to the front. But as you can see here in the replay, it clearly was offside. No reason to complain. The GDR virtually asked for a card. Obviously, the GDR was not in the mood to pack up here. But finally, after 19 running minutes of time, Indonesia wins! Indonesia is the new world champion of Helmer, to the surprise of all. Who would have thought of this outcome of the game? Look at the cheering world champion! Look at those cheering crowds! Indonesia won the game! Their team came too! Never before I've seen a team captain being so happy! Directly after the match, fans from all over the world celebrated the victory of Indonesia. It seems as if the GDR finally collapsed after 40 years of world domination in the game of Halma. Meanwhile in Jakarta, road traffic broke down because too many fans celebrated the victory on the streets. What a great day in the history of Halma.
I'm standing next to the new Halma World Champion, Intan from Indonesia. It's about 15 minutes after your triumph over Petra Müller from the German Democratic Republic. It was a great fight. In the first minutes you seemed to be very excited. Is that right?
Sorry, yeah. My English not part of the full one. Yeah, right. I am excited. This was because this came my first international one. Then I never know many people looking at me.
Can you explain what emotions you are feeling at the moment?
Now I'm happy that, because I win already. I never know I can, but I'm happy also game one finish already.
What did your preparation for this exciting final look like in the last days?
Last time I trained very hard, 8 hours in one day. I trained strategy, tactic, and with training.
We've all seen how hard it was for you to beat an opponent from the GDR. To what extent did your coach help you during this amazing game?
She gave me water and nutrients and motivated me.
In the 83rd minute, the referee decided that one of your opponent's pieces was offside. What was your impression of that scene?
The one offside, yeah. And then decision right one. She cannot do like this, but they have never affected her.
Thank you very much. It was a great pleasure speaking to you.